artillery fire. Major Bouchard said it was a jerk, but he kept moving and opening from trench to motivate his company, inspiring up his men and bolstering their spirit. Right then, a shell landed on the MMG post, and few of our soldiers got caught. Witnessing this great loss, Major Bouchard Singh roared, "My soldiers! They will have to pay for these debts with their own dead bodies! I will turn this land into their graveyard!" Major Bouchard Singh was bleeding, yet he entered the bunker and got hold of the MMG. Finally, entered Pakistan. Major Bouchard Singh was awarded for a Veer Chakra for exhibiting highest level of courage and valor. Yet another gallant story of the same Chakragarh sector. Equipped with T-55 tanks, 17 Poonar Horse was tasked to move ahead and clear the way. It was during this time that second lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, fearless as ever, attacked the enemy. He destroyed many of their tanks and was ultimately injured badly by the cannon being fired from the enemy. Still, he destroyed one more enemy tank. Then all of a sudden, heavy shelling by a Pakistani tank destroyed his tank. One served the country. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal was posthumously awarded the highest gallantry award of the Armed Forces of India, Paramveer Chakra, for exhibiting courage, valor, and fearlessness on the battlefield. Battle of Basantar continued for 12 days, from 4th December to 16th December. Both the countries suffered severe losses in this battle, but India captured 1,000 square kilometers of Pakistan's territory with almost 500 villages. On 14th December 1971, six Sabre jets of the Pakistani Air Force attacked Shrinagar airfield amidst heavy firing from Pakistani jets. Flying officer Nirmal Jain Singh Sinha successfully took to air with his man fighter plane within 2 minutes. In the ensuing minute, Nirmaljit Singh Sinha's voice cried on the radio. A few moments later, Nirmaljit Singh Sinha destroyed one Pakistani jet in front of him in the dogfight and blasted another plane next to it. Meanwhile, rest of the enemy fighters surrounded Nirmaljit Singh Sinha. Seeing himself getting surrounded, he transmitted,
"I think enemy has come in this side. Come on, it is your last time."
Enemy's attack resulted in fire on board Nirmaljit Singh Sinha's plane. He tried to land it, but due to control system failure, his fighter crash landed on the hills. Nirmaljit Singh Sinha was decorated with the highest military award, Paramveer Chakra, posthumously. Pakistan's 1st Armored Division planned to capture Jaisalmer. Their first target was Longewala. Longewala post, evening 6 o'clock.
Alpha 1, message over. Alpha 1. Okay, pass your message over. Alpha 1, one entire tank regiment of Pakistan is approaching Longewala post. Over. Roger. That is why they are using artillery fire in the sky to fight on a falling tank. If you can see our circles and slow down the enemy as much as possible by observing artillery fire.
All stations Alpha. RCL gun atop dune shall engage enemy tanks at my orders.
Sir, we have captured one soldier of Pakistani patrol.
Tell me about your plan.
We were told that we would have breakfast in Jaisalmer and lunch in Jodhpur. And the night we shall feast in Delhi.
All stations Alpha, leave Jodhpur and Delhi. We will give them a taste of our Karakasha.
Jodhpur is over.
The enemy tried to capture the Longewala post, but got caught in a minefield and could not proceed any further. Minefield was cleared and the attack continued on 5th December in the morning. Major John Puri until sunrise, when the Indian Air Force will join the battle, Major John Puri was tactical packet, moved his RCL gun and fired at enemy tanks from multiple locations. The enemy was led to believe that there is an entire battalion at the Indian Air Force. The Indian soldiers fired on the tanks at the back of the tanks, causing blasts and entering nearby enemy infantry. Keeping with the highest traditions of gunfire and courage, Major John Puri and his Alpha Command successfully kept enemy at bay for the surprise.
Thank you. officers and 176 men. The date of 16th December 1971 was made remarkable and unforgettable by the Indian Armed Forces in the global history. On this day, Pakistan forces had to face an embarrassing defeat. 93,000 Pakistani soldiers surrendered before the Indian Armed Forces. The world map was changed forever and a new nation. Bangladesh was born on the world map. On the evening of 16th December at 4 p.m., the chief of East Pakistan Forces Operations, Lieutenant General Amir Abdul Khan Niazi, was brought in front of thousands of Bangladeshis in the Dhaka Race Course. With the teary eyes, Lieutenant General Niazi took out his pistol tied on his waist and laid it down to the Indian Forces Chief of Eastern Pakistan Operations, Lieutenant General Jagjeet Singh Arora. He signed the document of surrender in front of thousands of people and thus accepted Pakistan's defeat.